A good build plate can make or break your 3D prints. Some are too sticky, some just don't stick enough. But this one claimed to be just right. The BQ Panda Cryo Grip build plate is supposed to have really good adhesion, easy releasing, and just be zero hassle for the most part. Let's find out if it's worth your money. This is only going to be good for PLA and PETG, very similar to what we would find on the Bamboo Lab equivalent SuperTac build plates. This is also available in two different sizes for the Bamboo Lab printers. You have the full size here, which comes in at about $24, and they also make one for the A1 Mini, which is about $20. Now, I do need to note that BQ and Big Tree Tech did send this to me at no charge for me to check out, but that's not gonna influence what I have to say about this. There is a lot of good, but there is one bad that I did run into. One thing that I do like is right on the build plate itself, they have printed on the QR code that's recognizable for the X1C, so that way you know that you put the right build plate on. Like most build plates today, this is dual-sided, which is good because, like I said, there is a bad coming up in this video, and it's a good thing that this is double-sided. Also, when you are using this build plate, do not use isopropyl alcohol on this. You will damage the coating. Only use soap and water to clean this thing up. Now, on paper, this thing sounds awesome, but specs don't always tell the full story. Let's actually test this thing out and see what I really think about it. Now, talking about the adhesion for this build plate, it has done phenomenally. I actually have not had really any issues with this. It has been just as good as the Bamboo Lab SuperTac, as long as it's clean. I mean, that goes for just about any build plate, right? So as long as this thing is clean, adhesion is phenomenal. And just like the Bamboo Lab SuperTac build plate, you don't have to actually heat up this build plate for things to attach to it. Now, I have done some zero heat tests with this where in the slicer, I will set it to 1 degree Celsius. So that way, realistically, it's not gonna heat up the build plate. Inside the garage where I'm filming and most of my printing is done, it's about 75 degrees if I'm lucky, sometimes warmer. Like for instance, right now, it's 80 degrees in here. This build plate does call for anywhere between 30 to 50 degrees Celsius for PLA and anywhere between 50 and 70 for PETG. Now, I have done tests with both of those at doing the 1 degree Celsius tests, and they have worked both times without any issues. Now, realistically, unless you're doing a ton of printing, you might not see a huge difference on your electrical bill, but if you are doing a ton or if you have multiple printers, you can definitely notice the difference with this, I would feel like. Prints do release from this fairly easily. I'd say it's actually a lot easier than, say, the Bamboo Lab SuperTac build plate. This, you can let it cool off and then you'll be able to kind of do the flex test and it'll actually pop the model off, which is a lot better than, say, the Bamboo Lab SuperTac build plate, where sometimes you do need the scraper to get it off. One advantage that this has over, say, the Bamboo Lab SuperTac build plate is the fact that I have done quite a bit of printing with this, and so far it's held up fairly well with one exception.
Oh no, I just went to go pull these off the build plate, and it appears that the build plate kind of came with the print. That's not good. And of course, I did let this cool overnight and it still didn't release very easily. This is PETG, which it is rated for, and it did cool, but it definitely took some of the build plate with it. That sucks.
Now, this definitely could have been my fault, but I did reach out to BQ and Big Tree Tech about this, and they are telling me that it's probably just a one-off issue and they're going to be replacing my build plate. But I just wanted you to know, just because this is something to keep in mind. This build plate has great adhesion. You're not gonna need any glue or anything like that to use this. It does release prints very well, better than I would say with the Bamboo Lab SuperTac. So overall, is this build plate worth it? I think so. Coming in at about $20 and $24 respectively, I think it's a no-brainer if you want a new build plate to play around with. But before you even think about buying the Bamboo Lab SuperTac build plate, you really should check out this video right here where I check it out and do a review on it. The BQ Panda The BQ Panda Cryo Grip.